smoking. Ooh, Lord, I'm choking. Ooh, Lord, I'm smoking grass. I'm smoking weed. 'Cause I don't need your fucking job.
Fat motherfucker.
Thank you for joining us, everybody. That was beautiful.
That's by Nice Peter, which is not a compliment on a porn set. It's the name of an artist.
Okay, glad that you could all help with that. Yeah. Yeah, see, the chat room feels so much better now.
Yeah, do we all feel better? We are all excised of that that pent-up fuckery.
Yeah, I mean, seriously, it's been like fucking 8 months since we've had one of those.
It's been a long time.
Yeah.
Been a long time.
You
about
don't
time.
Do it every day, just like no, once in a while. It's a surprise, and everybody goes, oh my God,
actually,
I need to do it.
That is actually the first official 420radio.org Fuck It Friday.
Yeah. Yeah,
oh, it's so. Fuck It Friday.
Fuck It Friday, yeah.
Oh, wow.
But it's not every Friday.
No. We can't just know.
Okay, yeah.
It's just like... If it was every Friday, then, you know, fuck, people would get so fucking tired.
Do you announce it that Fuck It Friday's coming up?
No.
It's a fucking surprise.
It's Fuck It Friday.
It's a fucking surprise. That's part of the fun of it, right? But every now and then we have to get that out, because when you're fighting the drug war and the prohibition, and the more truth you know about it, the more idiotic
say, fuck.
It becomes. You're just like, fuck. Yeah.
Fuck cancer. Fuck prohibitionists.
It's
you
just
know,
awful.
Fuck. You know, government officials who vote against medical marijuana bills and then they get caught with it in their car.
cat.
That happens all the time.
Just happened.
I mean, there's a job I worked that it happened to.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I mean, like, there was a job that I had in Estacada.
Okay.
I'm not going to say the business, but they make their own beer there, so figure that out.
Cool.
The first time I interviewed the woman, you know, she says, well, what is your show about? Because I really felt like I almost got the job. She's like, here's my number. Call me if you want the job, and then we'll go from there. I'm like, okay, cool. She goes, so what's your show about? I go, oh, it's about the legalization of marijuana. She goes, oh, well, we don't support that. You know, it's like she came, like the witch came out with a hat and everything.
Yeah.
And I get you, my hat,
and your little mom,
you know,
too.
And so I go, okay. And I'm going, boom, 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 like red light goes up, like, oh, I screwed up. Yeah. I know I lost the job, you know. And then she goes, well, we don't support that cause. She goes, my husband is a Republican druid who listens to Rush Limbaugh. And I was like, oh my
Holy
God,
crap.
I have got to meet that man.
This must be Oregon.
I go, this is a freak show. And so they eventually hired me, and I think they finally went through nobody worked out, so the women like, well, I guess we're just gonna have
last
to hire
resort.
We're gonna have to hire the marijuana girl.
Oh.
And they called me up and I got the job, and in order for me to do the job I had to sign a contract stating that I wouldn't talk about what my show was about to the customers.
Uh-huh.
But they had cameras like everywhere, all over their restaurant, like Big Brother.
Uh-huh.
And so I would talk to the customers and stuff like that. And they go, so what's your show about? And I go, well, are you on the internet? And I go, yeah, I am. I go, but you know, you might Google some stuff and you'll see some things about me that I'm not allowed to talk here at my job. Do you understand?
Yeah.
So now I sound like I'm like some sort of like freaking freak show.
Yeah.
Right? Like I sound like I'm like the porn star of the nation. Or
that's
you know,
one
maybe,
sure way to make them Google
I,
you.
Right? Like, who is this? You
know, well, what's then, all this about?
Then I got through the grapevine that they watched that on the footage at the job, and they were saying that I was, like, they were upset with me because I was outing myself to the customers, even though I had contractually signed that I wouldn't talk about it. I'm like, what am I, in the 1950s or something? I'm like, really? I go, this is Oregon. Like, you know what I mean? You grew like, you were the first state to legalize marijuana. Or what is wrong with you? And then I found out later on that they were smoking it themselves.
Oh, yeah. Of course.
I go, you are a hypocrite.
Well, you think Republicans don't smoke marijuana?
They just don't want you to.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, exactly. I mean,
they
like,
think
what?
Everybody can't handle it. Well, I mean, not just them. There's a lot of people out there who just say, well, marijuana is good for me, but, you know, there are some people who just never should smoke it, you know. And it's a strange mentality, but I've actually interacted with some of these people, you know.
It's just so weird, that whole obstacle. I mean, when I'm experiencing that, I'm like, am I really experiencing this?
Yeah, after
I mean,
all this like, time,
I
go, are we still
God,
have to go through
I mean,
that?
Like, yeah, I just feel like I go, so I, needless to say, I only last about 2.5 months there. And finally, I said, look, I think it's not working out on your end with me. And I go, and it's not working out on my end. So I think now's the time that I say goodbye. And they go, give us our shirt back.
Gladly.
And my paper hat, too.
Yes, had a million of those gigs, and but you're doing stand-up now, right?
Oh, yeah, yeah. You know, actually, I took the job because, like, when I first moved out here, I wanted to, like, focus on, like, you know, getting the shows launched with Michael. So I go, well, you know, I'll go back, I'll just do a job. And it would only be for the summer, and then that would give me enough time to book my comedy. So, yeah, I've been touring and stuff.
Awesome.
Yeah.